Kia ora. This is the electron configurations of ion simulation, and you can read what you need to do in this description. And what we're looking at is the electron configuration of the element, and then when we turn it into an ion by either adding or taking away electrons, what happens to the electron configuration then? So, starting off with hydrogen. Hydrogen is in group one, only has one electron, which goes into the 1s, so its electron configuration is 1s1. When I click on ionize, then you can see that that electron has gone, and it has no electron configuration because it doesn't have any electrons. Helium has got two electrons because its atomic number is 2, and if I try to ionize this, then you'll see it actually doesn't ionize very easily at all because it's very hard to remove those electrons. If I go to lithium, I have got 3 electrons, one of which is in the 2s. So if I try to ionize, my atomic electron configuration is 1s2, 2s1, which you see here, 1s2, 2s1. If I ionize, unfortunately, the simulation doesn't show it here, but you can see I've lost the 2s, and now the lithium plus ion is only 1s2. If I carry on, you can see, for instance, boron, it has 5 electrons and I can't actually ionize it. If I go to fluorine, fluorine has got 9 electrons in the neutral atom, so 2 plus 2 plus 5 is 9, and you can see I'm one short of a full second energy level. So when I ionize, then I form the F minus ion and I have a full second and first energy level because I've added another electron. You can do the same thing for the third row or the third energy level. And now let's look at the fourth row because that has some interesting anomalies. So potassium, remember the 4s gets filled before the 3d, because although the 4s is further out in terms of distance from the nucleus, it is actually lower in energy than the 3d. So it's the argon configuration plus 4s1. If I ionize it, then it has lost that 4s electron. And the same thing for calcium. It has 2 electrons in the 4s, none in the 3d. I ionize it and I form the calcium 2 plus ion. If I go to the scandium, scandium has got the 3d1, 4s2. So will it lose those? Will it lose that one? Will it lose all three? Scandium in this case actually loses all three to form the scandium 3 plus ion. That's the most common ion that it'll form. If I go to iron as an iron metal, then you can see I've got the 4s2, which gets filled before the 3d. But when I ionize, then, as I say, it's a good thing to remember the first to fill, first to flee, 4s first, then 3d. The 4s gets filled before the 3d, and the 4s also gets emptied before the 3d. So if I ionize, notice that the 4s electrons have gone, but the 3d, those 6 3d electrons still stay. But I can ionize again because that's the Fe2 plus ion. I can lose another one, that's 6 electron, so now I've got a partially filled 3d energy level or 3d orbitals, and so that gives some stability to the Fe3 plus ion. And you can try for zinc as well. It's got the 4s and a full 3d, so when I ionize, remember it goes from the 4s before the 3d. So its electron configuration would be 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 3d10, with nothing in the 4s. Your copper and your chromium still has some anomalies, which you can explore, and you can work out all the ones. So for instance, selenium, it has 3d10, 4s2, 4p4, and if I ionize, you can see we are just too short of a full 4p orbitals. Actually selenium doesn't because those electrons are too far away, but bromine does. It's only one short, and so there's a strong enough attraction to attract another electron, and so when I ionize, then that is full and I get the Br minus ion. So have fun exploring this, especially the transition metals, and then it'll hopefully make you remember them better. Goodbye.